Hello guys, welcome back to my channel VFX Expert. So guys, in this today's class we are going to see how to solve our camera, and also we will see how to use parameter adjustment window inside 3D equalizer. So let's start the class here. So now guys, here in 3D equalizer, so here in our previous class I have tracked this shot with the help of 2D tracking or manual tracking here. So here left side in our this point browser, you can see all these points just I have tracked for our this shot here. So simply you can select it here. So this point just I have tracked for this shot here. Then hold Alt and just click outside. So this will actually deselect your point here. So before solving our camera, suppose if you want to export your these 2D point, then you can also export in 3D equalizer for your further use here. So suppose here these points I want to export. So simply just select all these points. So I have selected first one, then hold Shift, then select last one, then right click on these points. So here you will get this export 2D point option. So just simply click here, then from here just you can select your folder or directory. Then so suppose inside our this 3D project folder, just I am going to save our point. So this will just create a notepad file and this will save your all these 2D points here. So now just give a name, so maybe track points. Then click on OK here. Then again nothing we have to change. Then finally just click on OK here. So now here just I have saved over these 2D points here. So suppose further if you want to import these points, then you can easily import and you can solve your camera here. So just I'm going to delete all these points here suppose. So just simply select all these points and just delete here. So press simply delete. So here it's saying delete point 23, mean 23 point just I am going to delete. So just click on delete selected points here. So now here just I have deleted all these points here. So now again just I am going to import our point which I have saved here. So for this in our this object browser, if you will see, so here you will get this point group options. Then in our this point group, just simply open this one. Then here you will get our points here. Then right click on these points. So here you will get again import 2D tracks here. Then click here. Now just select our file which we have saved. So this file just I have saved for our points here. Then select this notepad file here. Then click on OK. So here actually we will get two options. First, always create new points and replace existing point if possible. Means if suppose if there is any point which is just same name, so this will automatically replace if you will select this option. But here just there is no any point, so I am going to use always create new points here. Then press OK here. So now here if you will see, so I have imported our all point which I have saved for this shot here. So like this just you can track your point and you can save, and further you can again import your points and you can just solve your camera here. So now finally just I am going to solve our camera here. So before solving our camera, if you have your camera information or lens information, then you have to enter before solving our camera. So this is again important things in 3D equalizer. So in our this object browser downside, if you will see this lens information, so just simply select this lens. So right side in our this attribute editor, here you will get these lens parameters here. So if you know your maybe lens film back, height, width, even focal length, then simply you can type it here before solving your camera. But because this is an unknown shot, so I don't have any information about this shot. So on default value, just I am going to solve our camera here. But if you have information, so remember this one. So here we have to type, then you have to solve our camera. Now finally, downside in our main menu, you will get this calc menu here. Then click here. Then finally click on calc all from scratch. So now here if you will see, this is our actually 3D camera solve window here. So with the help of left mouse button, we can orbit. Then middle mouse button, we can pan, and right mouse button, just we can zoom. So here you will get these are our actually point which I have tracked, and this is our actually 3D points here, and this red line which is our actually camera path here or camera movements here. Then here downside you will get two options. First, use result. Then second, discard result. Means so suppose if you feel this result is good according to your path, then simply you can click on use result. Otherwise just simply discard result here and just create some more points, and again you can solve your camera. But this is sufficient for us Then simply click on use result here. Then again click on this calc here. So now here just I have solved my camera here, and left side in our the deviation browser you will get this deviations error, which is our actually 0.3143 here. This is our actually average deviations value here, and this is our actually per frame error here. So if you will move your playhead, so you will get here 0.2, then here if you will see 0.26, then here little bit 0.37, so little bit high like this. So this is our actually per frame deviations error here. So what is actually deviations error? So deviations error mainly actually difference between 2D points and 3D points here. But if you will see here in our this viewer, these red points, these are our actually only 2D point, not it's not showing 3D points here. So in our this manual tracking controls, if downside, if you will see here 3D points option, so we have to enable our this 3D point option after solving our camera, then only we can see 3D point inside our this manual tracking control viewer here or inside our this window here. So just we have to enable our these 3D points here. So now only we can see our these 3D points here. So now just a little bit zoom here. So here you will get these red point whichever 2D point, and these green point whichever 3D points here. So difference between these points, so these red point positions and this green point positions, difference between these positions is called our deviations error or deviations value here. So this should be below one pixel, means this is acceptable here, but we have to just make it near to zero here. Okay, now if you will see deviation whichever actually 0.31 here, so this is little bit good here, so we can use this result here. But suppose little bit if you want to enhance your camera solve, then you can still enhance your camera solve. So first just I am going to just adjust some values here, maybe focal length, even some distortion here. So in real life most of the shot has little bit distortion here, so just two values just I am going to adjust for this shot here. First this focal length, second one whichever this distortion here. So for this first in our this again lens information in focal length, just simply click here and just click on this adjust. Then second one in distortion degree 2, just I am going to adjust. Then again click on this adjust. Then again come here in our this main menu and click on windows and just click on this parameter adjustment window. So whatever parameter just you have selected here with this adjust option, so this will add here. So this is our actually focal length and second one whichever distortion here. So these two parameters just I am going to adjust for this shot here. So downside here you will get actually two options. So first this brute force option, second adaptive all option. Just select first this one. Even if you want, you can also select this adaptive option here. Now click on this adjust here. So now here you can see, so 3D equalizer is automatic adjustment this one. So again with the help of left mouse button, just you can orbit this window here easily. So now here you can see new deviation value whichever 0.30 here. So little bit improvements here. Then finally click on transform parameter. Then again we have to solve our camera. Remember this one, after adjusting all these parameters, again we have to solve our camera or we have to calculate our camera. So just simply click here, then click on calc all from scratch, then only this will update here. So now simply click it here. So now again same thing, these are our 3D point and this is our camera path or camera movements here. So now use result here. So now here you can see here, again click here. So now here if you will see here, we have just improved our camera solve here. So now simply play and check here, little bit just zoom here. So but here if you will see here, actually these green point is not just exact place at perfect position, because here you have actually undistorted our little bit plate here. So we have to also check our this 3D distortion here, then only you will get here final result here, because here just we have checked about this 3D point but not distortion points here. So just simply check it, this 3D distortion point. So now here you will see here, so now we are getting our final output after adjusting all these parameters here. Even suppose if you want to check distortion, then you can switch this manual tracking control with lineup controls here. So inside our this lineup window, simply we can just hide and show over this distortion value here. So now if you will see here, this is our final result after undistorting our plate here. But if you want to check your original plate, then simply you can just switch off this one undistort. So now you can see here, so this is our original plate and this is our bit undistort here, whatever just I have undistorted with this value here. Okay, so here just this is just only for checking here, so easily we can see here. So now again simply come here in our this manual tracking controls here, and so now just play and check here. So suppose still if you want to enhance your camera solve, then just I am going to explain how you can actually just check your per points error, and you can delete your higher error points, even you can adjust your higher error points if there is any problem here. So now finally just I am going to show you here per points error here. Then for this simply click on this deviation browser here, then downside here you will get this show point deviation curve here, click, then downside you will get all points here. So now here if you will see these actually blue points, this is our actually per points path here or error here. Hold alt and just select this line. So this is our actually this points error here, or you can say our path here. So now here this is our actually little bit high error points here, so usually we can see. So if you want, you can delete this point from our this sort, or just we can check where is our error and we can adjust this point. But here just I am going to delete these points here. So simply just I have selected from here, even from here you can also select. So suppose here if you want to deselect your point, then simply hold alt and just click outside here. So this would deselect your points. So again simply hold alt and just select your points here. Now simply press delete here. Now just delete points here, one point selected, then delete selected points here. So now here just I have deleted. So again we have to solve our camera, or we have to calculate our camera. So remember this one, whatever you are doing for enhancing your camera, so again you have to calculate your camera solve. This is the most important thing in 3D equalizer here. So again just click on calc and calc all from scratch here. Again use result here. So now you can see here improvements, which is our 0.22 here. So this is too good for us. Even if you want, we can just use this solutions here. Now again click on finally full frame here. So like this, just you can find your higher point, then you can delete, then again if you want you can just add another point and you can track your shot, then again you can solve your camera here. So finally just simply close this panel here, deviation browser here. So this is sufficient for us. So this is our final solve here. Now simply play and check. So you can see all these our green points here and these red points, which are 2D points here. So now finally just I'm going to see how actually just we can see our all these points in our 3D view here, or 3D equalizer 3D view here. So for this, just simply again we have to click on this manual tracking. Then here downside you will find this 3D orientation control or 3D view here. Just simply click here. So here again right mouse button you can zoom, left mouse button you can orbit, and middle mouse button simply you can pan. So here you will get this is our actually camera path, which is very smooth here, and these are our 3D points here which we have tracked for this sort here, these green points here. So now simply play and check, and this is our image plane here. So now just play and check. So here you can see our this camera path. So suppose here if you want to suppose hide your image plane, then simply you can click on this view, then click on show image plane, then simply none here. So this will not actually display image plane here. So like this, just you can hide your image plane. So easily we can see. So suppose just only for testing purpose, I am going to create one test object here, which is our cube here. So this is just only for testing purpose here. So simply if you want to create your test object, then again click on this 3D models, then click on create. Then here just I am going to just select our maybe this cube here. So now here if you will see in our this 3D view here, so just I have created our this cube here. Now again I click here and just come here in our this manual tracking. Suppose whatever 3D object if you will create, so this will not display in our this manual tracking control. So this object you can see in our this lineup control here, or in our this overview control here. But here just I am going to select our this lineup control here, so easily we can see our, so this is our actually horizon line. So if you want to hide this line, then simply click on this view and just click on show and hide here this one horizon line. So this will actually hide this line here, so easily we can focus our object. So remember this one, here we are inside our this lineup control. So now simply just a little bit zoom and play and check. So easily we can see this is our 3D model here. So suppose even if you want to place your 3D model at your desired positions here, then easily you can place. So suppose here just I want to place, so hold alt and easily we can select over this point, whichever point 12 years. So here just I want to place our this 3D model here. So again, then after this come here in this 3D orientation view. So this is our actually point where just I want to place our cube. So point I have selected, then hold Alt and Shift, then you can select your 3D model like this. Then we have to click on again this 3D model, then snap two points here. So now just I have snapped over this point at over this 3D point or locator positions here. So now again just simply come here in over this lineup control. So easily we can see here. Now if you want to suppose just adjust size of your this 3D model here or test object, then again we have to come here in 3D orientation control here. So now just right mouse button, so just a little bit zoom out. So first we have to deselect over all these points or object here. So hold Alt and just click outside here. Then again we have to select only our this 3D model here. So hold Alt and just select this one. Even in our this 3D model option left side, you can also select model like this. Then here downside you will get our some transform option. So with the help of translate, you can move your object, then rotate, then scale. So just simply click on scale. So here you will get these controllers here. So just we have to pick only these corner points here. So uniform we can scale it here. And suppose if you will pick this one, so this will actually just break your proportion here, this object, okay? So now just simply to scale it here. Now again come here in this lineup control. So you can see here, even suppose here just I want to place. So again hold Alt and just select this one, whichever point 17 here. Then again come here in this lineup control. And just again first click here. And so here both things just I have selected. Then again click on 3D points and snap to points here. Now again come here in this lineup controls here. So easily we can see. Now just play and check here. So now guys, here if you will see this 3D object or test object just placed on our this shot here, and this is looking good here. So just stop it here and just simply click on this first frame option. So guys, till here I have successfully solved our camera, and also just I have enhanced our camera, and also just I have created our this 3D object into our this scene here. So in next class we will continue on same project, and we will see scene orientation, scene scaling, then how to create multiple test object inside over this scene here. So guys, if you like this video, please watch, share, comment and subscribe my channel if you are still not subscribed my channel. So thanks for watching.